Episode 2, Measures of Pregnancy-Related and Maternal Mortality. In this episode, we will discuss the common measures of pregnancy-related and maternal mortality. The goal of this episode is to understand key measures of maternal mortality and how to calculate them. While we will discuss the measures as used for maternal mortality, they can be applied to pregnancy-related mortality as well. We will discuss the following indicators of maternal mortality and how to calculate them. MMR or MM ratio, that's maternal mortality ratio. MM rate, that's maternal mortality rate. PM or PMDF, proportion of maternal deaths among deaths to women of reproductive age. LTR, lifetime risk of maternal death. As discussed earlier, these can be calculated either for maternal deaths or pregnancy-related deaths. To calculate measures of pregnancy-related mortality, whenever the inputs require number of maternal deaths, you can use number of pregnancy-related deaths. When you use pregnancy-related death rather than maternal deaths, it is important to specify which is being used, since the definition is different, as we discussed in the previous episode. The first indicator we will discuss is maternal mortality ratio, or MMR. You may also see it written as MM ratio. The MMR is the number of maternal deaths in a given time period divided by the number of live births during the same period. It is usually multiplied by 100,000. This is the most common measure that you will see on maternal mortality. The primary target for the third Sustainable Development Goal is expressed in terms of reducing MMR. The approximate global range is from 5 to 1,000 per 100,000 live births. By expressing maternal death per live birth rather than per women of reproductive age, the MMR is designed to express obstetric risk. Do you see any problem with this? By putting live birth in the denominator, we may be overestimating risk. Denominator should be larger and include pregnancies that does not result in live births. The MMR is often confused with maternal mortality rate. This is why some people choose to write it as MM ratio rather than just MMR. As I mentioned in the previous slide, if you only have pregnancy-related deaths, if you do not have any cause of death data to exclude incidental or accidental deaths, you can use the number of pregnancy-related death instead of maternal death in the calculation. But if you do that, you are producing pregnancy-related mortality ratio, or PRMR, instead of maternal mortality ratio. It is very important to note the difference, so they are not used interchangeably. Maternal mortality rate is the number of maternal deaths per woman years lived at ages 15 to 49. It is usually multiplied by 1,000. The MM rate is a cause-specific death rate. Because it is a cause-specific death rate, it allows for comparisons with other causes of death, particularly in terms of ranking. It is often an intermediate step in the calculation of the MMR. Proportion maternal, or PM, or sometimes called PMDF, is the proportion of maternal deaths among all female deaths during reproductive ages. The range is from less than 1% in developed countries to about 45% in developing countries. It is often used as a starting point for estimation purposes. Lifetime risk of maternal death is the probability that a woman who reaches reproductive age would die eventually from a maternal cause, taking into account competing causes of death. In countries where there is a high risk of maternal death, the risk of girls dying before reaching reproductive age is also high. So a measure of lifetime risk conditional on girls' survival to reproductive age makes sense. It ranges from around 1 in 20 in some countries to as low as 1 in 45,000 or very close to zero. There are many ways of calculating lifetime risk. The formula shown here in this slide illustrates the concept. We will not be calculating lifetime risk in this course. The slide shows how these measures are related to each other. As you can see, you can calculate MMR or maternal mortality ratio from PM or proportion maternal. Similarly, you can calculate MM rate or maternal mortality rate from proportion maternal. MMR can also be calculated from MM rate and GFR, or the general fertility rate. These conversions will come in handy later on when we discuss the methods for adjusting maternal deaths. To further illustrate the differences between the measures, let's take a look at some indicators from the Demographic Health Surveys, or DHS. These are all pregnancy-related indicators. Let's look at the Democratic Republic of Congo's pregnancy-related mortality ratio, or PRMR. The PRMR in the DRC in 2007 was about 553 per 100,000 live births. It was much lower than Malawi's PRMR in 2004, which was about 975. Now let's look at the proportion pregnancy-related. Although the PRMR in the DRC was lower than that of Malawi, when you look at the proportion pregnancy-related, the proportion pregnancy-related was higher in the DRC at 19% than in Malawi, which was at 16.8%. Now let's look at Zambia and Mali. Zambia has a higher PRMR than Mali at 584 compared to 439 per 100,000 live births. But Mali's proportion pregnancy-related at 27.1% is much higher than Zambia's 8.7%. When you look at the lifetime risk of pregnancy-related death, however, both countries are about the same at around 3.3 and 3.4. So as you can see, different indicators tell you different stories, and one indicator is not necessarily better than the other. It is best to look at multiple indicators to understand the trend. Also, keep in mind that the trend may not be the same across indicators, as you can see here. As I mentioned earlier, the MMR is the most widely used maternal mortality indicator, so it is important to keep in mind some considerations when using MMR. First, MMR is not age standardized. This is an issue because there is strong association of per-pregnancy risk and age. Also, this makes a measure less comparable across countries than other measures for mortality, like the infant mortality rate or life expectancy. Second, the risk is expressed as per 100,000 live births, so a value of 553 implies a misleading sense of accuracy. Also, the MMR is a cause-specific indicator. Therefore, it is more demanding data-wise than other summary mortality indicators. Other things to consider about the MMR are that it does not reflect the fact that women may face this risk per birth several times over her lifespan. Also, the changes in the MMR are a result of changes in any of or all of the following: the risk of maternal deaths, distribution of birth by risk factors, and the age distribution of women. What we want to understand in changes in the MMR is the changes in the risk of maternal deaths. We would like to see better healthcare for mothers that lead to reduced risk of maternal death. But because MMR indicator is the number of maternal deaths per 100,000 live births, any changes are confounded by changes in births and the age distribution of women. For example, the risks of maternal death generally increases for women over the age of 40. If over a 10-year period, the proportion of women over the age of 40 giving birth increases, then an apparent rise in MMR may be due to the increasing age at which women give birth, rather than a true increase in the risk of maternal deaths. Unless we do a more detailed analysis, this difference would not be apparent by just looking at the MMR. So the interplay between maternal mortality and fertility is not entirely clear. When you see differences in MMR, it could be differences in births, differences in deaths, or differences in age distribution of women. So when you are interpreting differences in MMR that you see over time or across space, keep in mind that the differences could be due to a number of factors and conduct a more thorough investigation. In this episode, we discussed four measures of maternal mortality: MMR, or maternal mortality ratio, MM rate, or maternal mortality rate, PM, or proportion of maternal deaths among deaths to women of reproductive age, and LTR, lifetime risk of maternal death. Of these, the MMR is most commonly used, and the SDGs are reported in terms of MMR. This concludes Module 1 of the e-learning course on estimating maternal mortality from census data. In Module 2, you will learn about census questionnaire design, training, and tabulation. Thanks for tuning in.